out.
Writing from the Old Kingdom.
Hey, have you talked to this girl you like?
I didn't say I liked her. We were friends, but she's being strange and avoiding me.
Maybe because she likes you too. We often do not say what we mean. It will come to you in bursts.
Why would she avoid me if she likes me?
This is something your mother should explain. I am better with the stars. The goldfish, called Capricornus by the Greeks. The god has the head of a ram and the body of a fish. You see? Even the gods do not always make sense. That is the last one. I can take all the shards back to Siwa now.
I'm going to find every stone circle, the Sphinx and pyramids too, and I'll find my place.
My son. Your name, Hemu, means Egypt. Like Egypt. You are forever changed.
stars are yours now. And your place is with them.
Could this be the golden light I heard about? What is this place? What sort of men are these?
To the dead wizard!
Writing in the Old Kingdom.
lucky to be alive. I was attacked by corpses, dressed like soldiers.
I met them myself. How did you come to be here?
I came in search of the lost army of Cambyses.
That is an old legend. Thousands of men lost forever in a sandstorm.
I believe they carried much gold. As I approached, I saw a golden light. At last, I thought the gods have chosen me for the treasure of the lost army.
Are you an adventurer or a grave robber?
A man must live. I entered and saw many bodies, dead these centuries, and beyond them, a glowing object. I grabbed it and immediately heard strange sounds. I quickly loaded it onto my camel, when suddenly, horrifying soldiers attacked. The camel fled into the desert.
Yeah. I will help you get to safety.
No. You must find my camel and bring back the glowing object. I am certain that it brought the lost army back from the dead.
I will find out what happened. Stay hidden here. What are they doing?
Oh,
poor animal.
this is it. I must return it to its place and end this nightmare. That wind will raise the sound. I have recovered the object! Where has he gone? Are you here? Something must be behind here. Let's get you where you belong.
Thank you. Yeah. Where am I?
Ah, you are awake at last. We found you wandering dazed in the desert.
Where's the adventurer? And the object?
We found only you, muttering about the lost army.
I battled with soldiers returned from the Duat.
Let us pray you were simply overcome by heat. These strange rumors from Thebes terrify everyone. Pray, Osiris, that none are true. That eagle deserves your thanks. Nomad saw it circling in the desert.
She is a good friend.
The Great Sphinx. It is smaller than I expected. Hidden entrance. How long has this been here?
Thank you. Retransmission. Segment 6. Acquiring contemporaneity. It has been 109 days since the Great Catastrophe. The Messenger speaks.
Wake up. Not from a dreamless sleep or an absence of light, but from a reality that will soon cease to be. Wake up. The next chapter is unstoppable. And yet, the greatest revolutions sometimes originate from the confines of impossibility, do they not? Change your mind, subvert your perception, stop this world, bend it into something new. Destiny is not without irony. Here I am, imploring a lesser version of myself to do what I could never do. In this timeless moment, you and I are a bridge, both of us from different eras meeting halfway at the narrowing of the hourglass in this ocean of sand. It is not enough to tell time. You must learn time. To work with your shielding Mrs. East Light, and in so doing, escape the inescapable. Fill in the blanks, the ones hiding between words, between worlds. Find the spaces that we could not erase, the variables that ended up erasing us. If you do not, they will erase you as well. Time told of a story that ended with us, and now it tells of a story that ends with you. Once upon a time, a new story will begin. After the functions which run our days have scattered into an array of random numbers, we found solace in order. We thought it would help us rule the world. We were wrong. Order never served us. It has kept us within the code, within the boundaries. We were tricked into thinking we were the ones writing the rules, when they were in fact guiding us to our conclusion. You need to transgress. You of all people understand the value of disobeying. Take an unexpected turn away from the path that is drawn straight ahead of you. The Animus was humankind's first unconscious attempt to explain what it could not see. Understanding genetic memories, an eye into history. But the Animus bears a fatal flaw. It follows the rules from those who embrace order, just as we do. It allows you to witness, but not alter. Your Animus is different, as is the mind that imagined it. It could escape the code. It could do that leap and make possible a decision that defies the order of things that are. Wake up. Be the chaos that comes to be. Gods are just like you and me. Remember. Nothing is real. Everything is permitted.
Thank you.
105 days since the great catastrophe. The messenger speaks.
The color blue. We believe everyone sees it as we do. Ocean, sky, international Klein blue. What's to say yours and mine are of the same hue? Do you truly see it as I do? Frequencies so high, only a few can hear their cue. A heightened response to the taste of food. Colors invisible to the human eyes, save for a few. A high voice, perceived as living glass. Perceptions shape reality. Colorblindness, tinnitus, supertasting, tetrachromacy, synesthesia. Reality is a mathematical model which gets solved over and over again by the observer. Your thoughts are computations, and they render this world for you to call your own. Not all processors are alike. Different brains produce different realities. The variations go from the subtle to the drastic. Your mind defines how much you can taste, how much you can feel, how much you can understand. Perception defines perspective. Where one sees a skull, the other sees a woman in a mirror. Where one hears silence, the other will hear entrancing voices. You experience what your brain allows you to perceive. We designed you and made sure to engineer your senses so you could perceive just what we needed you to, neither more nor less. There are parts of time we preferred you to remain blind to. It was a necessity. We have six senses, you have five. Can you guess the one missing? For centuries, humanity has fought for freedom. The real cage is not around you, it is in you. Your mind will not allow you to wander in uncharted territories. A Faraday cage for the mind. A concealed straitjacket. Events such as Upsweep and Julia fuel internet conspiracies. Sounds unknown, heard only once. A cabinet of curiosities for the modern age. And yet, they were messages just like this one. Waiting for their observer, their compatible processor. Human visionaries developed a vague awareness of their limits. They wrote obscure research papers, popular science fiction novels, some asking us to stop the world. But that's all they ever were, fictions. How could they not be? Reality is what the observer allows it to be. The Doppler effect, the Mobius strip, deja vus, cicada 3301, UVB 76, eureka effects, ambigrams and anamorphosis, P versus NP. Is Schrodinger's cat dead or alive? It all depends on what you perceive. On what the cage is not hiding for you to see. Think. Think. Let your mind be free. Explore the borders of your reality.
Say no.
There. One more.